Hey, what the hell is happening?
Shh, not so loud.
No, really, what's happening here?
You really do not know, do you?
I'm checking what's happening now.
Whatever this is, it's so dark.
Wait, what?
Why is everyone so loud? And what is happening?
The Smash Daylight's videos we'll see today!
For real? Ah, shoot! I forgot!
Well, I think we should just do the intro. C&G will probably not let the delay happen.
You were correct about that. Anywho, let us begin, shall we?
Hell yeah! Yuzuke, start us off!
Hello, audience.
We are very excited for you to come join and watch this special video by...
Smash Datalizers!
Is everyone ready?
I believe so.
Okay, then. Come on, Joker!
It's showtime!
Hey, this is CNJ Gamer from the Smash Datalizers, and I will be doing a very different video than usual, because I will talk about the first anniversary of Joker from Persona 5 being in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate as the first DLC fighter in the first Fighter's Pass. Joker was first announced at the Game Awards, the night before the release of Smash Ultimate. All we got was that Joker was coming in the springtime. After that reveal trailer, we did not get news for a long time about Joker. We only got some fake leaks, but we got some interesting data mines about Joker and his stage. First, his codename would be Jack, as in Jack of all trades, and that his stage would be Mementos, which made sense, since it is the main hub world in the metaverse. We also got a leak from Best Buy at the beginning of April, which showed off Joker's artwork for the game. Finally, on April 16th, we got a new video from Nintendo, which showed off Joker's moveset, and so much more. We first got the reveal of Joker's main moveset, which showed off that he would use his dagger as his main melee weapon, and that he would also utilize a gun, like in Persona 5. He also had a move called I-Hat, which is used differently in Smash than in Persona 5. Joker also got another move called the Grappling Hook, which is what the name describes it as basically. This weapon was not in Persona 5 as a mechanic, but it was actually in the menus of Persona 5. For the real use of the Grappling Hook, I guess it came from Persona 5. The Royal, but that game came out less than a year later. The gun had very cool mechanics by the way. Then, we saw that Joker would also utilize a Persona, which was none other than Arcane. Arcane looks really good in Smash, and his moveset is pretty cool. It basically is just Joker's moveset 2.0, with a stronger gun, Aegean instead of I-Hat, which has more range and was more stable, and a new up special, which was Wings of Rebellion, which was actually a reference to the Confidant Awakenings, and not a battle move. Finally, Joker's final Smash, All Out Attack, which looked as good as it did in Persona 5. Joker's victory theme is the victory theme in Persona 5 as well, and also Joker running around was from it as well. But enough about Joker, let us get into the stage, Mementos. Mementos is Joker's stage from Persona 5, and it is a little different than in Persona 5. But anyways, his stage also has temporary walls that came from the sides, and also subway trains below the stage. The coolest part of his stage is that you can change the look of the stage to a Persona 4 look, or a Persona 3 look, by changing the music. But now let us get into the music. Joker brought 11 music tracks with him. It included 5 Persona 5 music tracks, 3 Persona Music 4 tracks, and 2 Persona 3 music tracks, and a remix of a song from all Persona games from 3 to 5. The Persona 5 tracks are really good, with Last Surprise, the battle theme of Persona 5, a new remix of Beneath the Mask, which is such an amazing remix, and probably one of the best songs in Smash Ultimate by far, Rivers in the Desert, which is a fan favorite, and Our Beginning, which is a song at the end. You can expect the same for the Persona 4 and 3 songs, and the remix of Aria of the Soul is also good. Well, I am finished, I have said too much. But, what do you guys think? Tell me in the comments. So make sure to subscribe, share, and like this video, as well as to join the ANU Podcast Approaches Discord server, and to follow the Smash Datalizers Twitter, and I will see you guys later. Bye.